Hi guys! Welcome sa EngineNerdMa channel. Sa video na to, ituturo ko sa inyo ang introduction to probability. So kung gusto nyo itong matutunan, just keep on watching. Okay, so this time, ituturo ko naman sa inyo ang introduction to probability. So since meron na tayong background about fundamental principle of counting, factorial, combination, permutation, sets, operations on sets, and Venn diagram is pwede na tayo dumako sa mismong topic na probability kasi yun yung mga prerequisites nitong topic natin for probability. So pwede nyo rin panoorin yung mga previous videos ko about dun sa mga sinabi kong topics para mas maintindihan nyo itong probability. So dito sa introduction to probability is didefine lang natin kung ano ba ang probability, some terminologies, at kung paano yung formula natin sa paghanap ng probability. Okay? So sabi, probability measures the likelihood that a particular event will occur, which is expressed as a ratio or fraction. So yung probability is yung pag-measure natin ng likelihood ng isang particular event to occur. At ina-express natin yon as a ratio or fraction. So, pwede ring decimal and percentage. Okay? So, for example, sabi, the probability that you will get 8 correct in 10 item true or false exam, the probability that you can land on even number when you roll a die, the probability that you can pick an ace from a standard deck of cards. So, ito yung mga some examples lang na probability na pwede nating ma-encounter sa probability problems. Pero marami pa tayong pwedeng gamitan ng probability in real life applications. Okay? So sabi, in probability, each repetition of an experiment is a trial. A possible result of each trial is called an outcome. So sa probability, kapag meron tayong experiment, gumagawa tayo ng number of trials. Okay? So, sa bawat trial na yon, pwede tayong magkaroon ng outcome. So, halimbawa, yung experiment natin is tossing a coin. So, magta-trial tayo ng several times sa pag-toss ng coin. And then, yung outcome nitong pag-toss ng coin is pwedeng mag-land siya sa head or mag-land siya sa tail. Right? So, kung sa isang toss ng coin is kukuhain natin yung probability, let's say, probability P na mag-land siya sa heads, ang probability nyon is 1 half. At yung probability naman na mag-land siya sa tails, ang probability din ay 1 half. Paano naging 1 half? So, meron kasi tayong formula for probability na probability P of an event is equal to the number of favorable outcomes over total number of possible outcomes. So, ibig sabihin, kung yung kukuhain natin yung probability na mag-land siya sa heads, so, diba yung number of favorable outcomes natin is gusto nating maging heads. So, dalawa lang naman yung possible outcomes natin, diba? Sa pag-toss ng isang coin. Either mag-land siya sa head or tail. So, kung gusto nating heads, number of favorable outcomes sa numerator is isa lang. So, 1 over total number of possible outcomes. So, dalawa sila sa pwedeng heads and tails. So, ilan yun? 2. So, kaya 1 half yung probability. Likewise, kung tails din, so yung numerator natin is number of favorable outcomes for tail, isa lang din. So kaya 1 over total number of possible outcomes, heads and tails din, so 2 din. So total number of 2 possible outcomes din sa denominator. Okay? Now, the set of all possible outcomes is called sample space. So halimbawa dito sa example natin, the sample space for tossing a coin is yung possible outcomes, yung dalawa, di ba? Pwedeng heads and tails. So, pwede natin i-denote yung sample space as a set. Denote it as S. So, yung elements niya inside is dalawa, which is heads and tails. Application of sets, right? And then, yung number ng elements itong sample space is 2, right? So, kaya yung 2 yung nasa denominator natin. And then for the event, an event is any of the possible outcomes including all or none. So yung event natin dito sa probability na heads is, let's say, event H. Okay? So anong element niya? Isa lang kasi gusto natin maging heads, right? Kapag dito naman sa tail, pwede natin gawing event is, let's say, T. ang element ng set na yon is tail lang. Right? Kasi yun yung gusto nating favorable outcome. So, kaya yung number of elements ng event each is 1. Kasi each lang. So, yun yung numerator. And then, yung number of elements nitong event T is isa lang din. So, yun din yung numerator sa probability. Now, when the possible outcomes have the same chance of occurring, they are described as equally likely. They occur at random. So, halimbawa, doon sa example natin, in tossing a coin. So, di ba yung probability ng heads is 1/2. And probability ng tail is 1/2 din. So, therefore, meron tayong equally likely event. Kasi para sila ng probability na mag-occur. Okay? Now, sabi, the probability of an event that is impossible is 0. The probability of an event that is certain to happen is 1. All other probabilities are between 0 and 1. In general, for any probability, P of E. So, 0 is less than or equal to P of E, less than or equal to 1. Okay, so kapag yung probability ng isang event is impossible or hindi pwedeng mangyari, ang value niya is 0. Kapag sure naman tayo na mangyayari yung probability, ang probability niya is 1. So, kaya sinabi na yung range ng values ng probability natin for any probability event E is in between 0 and 1. So, kaya sinabi natin na usually fraction siya kasi in between siya 0 to 1 with 0 and 1 inclusive. So, kapag impossible, 0 yung probability. Kapag sure tayo, 100%, ang value ng probability is 1. Okay? Now, in a random experiment, the two situations that an event does occur and that the event does not occur are complementary events. So, halimbawa, in tossing a coin, so yung event natin, let's say na maglaland yung coin natin in heads, is complementary siya dito sa probability na maglaland naman siya sa tail. Kasi, dalawa lang naman yung possible outcome natin, right? So, kung hindi heads, tail yung magiging outcome. Likewise, kung hindi tail, head yung magiging outcome. So, therefore, complementary sila. So, pwede nating sabihin na probability of event E plus probability of its complement, let's denote it as E prime, is equal to 1. Okay? So, kapag inadd natin yung probability ng isang event at yung complement niya, laging ang sagot is 1. Halimbawa, dito sa probability nga natin ng heads at tails, so alam natin na para silang 1/2, right? So, 1/2 plus 1/2 is 1. Kasi, complementary sila. Okay? So, pwede nyo gawing formula ito kapag naka-encounter kayo ng two events na complementary. Okay? Now, sabi, odds are a ratio that compares a probability of an event to the probability of its complement. Okay, so pag sinabi nating odds, meron tayong dalawang case. Odds against and odds in favor. So pag sinabi nating odds in favor, ang formula is number of favorable outcome over number of unfavorable outcome. Kapag naman odds against, baliktad lang. So, number of unfavorable outcome over, so, urong ko, number of favorable outcome. So, odds against is number of unfavorable outcome over number of favorable outcome. And odds in favor is number of favorable outcome over number of unfavorable outcome. So, halimbawa natin is sa dice. Sa isang die. So, di ba sa die meron tayong 6 numbers. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, ito yung sample space natin sa dice. So, let's say, consider natin yung isang event E na kapag niroll natin yung die is makakakuha tayo ng number 1. So, 1 yung element niya. So, ano yung odds against natin tsaka odds in favor dito sa event E? So, dito muna tayo sa against. So, kapag against, number of unfavorable outcome. So, yung unfavorable outcome natin is yung ibang number other than 1. Kasi yun yung against sa gusto nating lumabas. Kasi gusto natin is 1, right? So, ano yung number of unfavorable outcome kapag gusto natin is 1? Yung natira, yung 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, ilan yun? 5, right? So, yun yung numerator. Over number of favorable outcome. So, isa lang. Kasi 1 yung gusto natin, right? Isa lang yung element ng event E. Over 1. So, 5 over 1 or 5. Now, kapag odds in favor, reciprocal lang nito. Kasi number of favorable outcome, which is 1 nga, over number of unfavorable outcome, which is 5. So, 1/5. So, odds against is 5 and odds in favor is 1/5. Okay, so yun yung definition natin and formula for odds. So, let's solve some examples para mas ma-illustrate natin ang concept ng probability. So, for the first one, we have what is the probability of getting A prime number, B odd number, C even number when rolling a single die. Okay, so die problem. So, doon muna tayo sa letter A. Probability of getting a prime number. So, kuhain muna natin yung sample space kapag magro-roll tayo ng single die. So, denote natin yung set na yon as sample space set S. Okay? So, ano yung elements natin dito? So, since meron tayong isang die, ang possible outcomes is 1 to 6, right? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or number of elements nitong set S is 6. Ngayon, para naman sa elements nitong prime number, so ano-ano yon from 1 to 6. So, denote natin as event P. So, ano-ano yung mga prime numbers from 1 to 6. So, 1, hindi siya prime number, right? 2, yes, prime number. 3, prime number. 4, hindi. 5, prime number. 6, hindi. So, as a review, prime number is a number whose factors are 1 in itself. Okay? So, therefore, yung probability ng event P or yung pag-roll ng prime number is number nung element nitong event P over number nung element ng sample space. So, ano number nung element nitong event P? So, 1, 2, 3. So, 3 over sample space, which is 6. So, 3 over 6 or 1/2. So, lagi yung i-reduce sa lowest term yung fraction. Okay? B, odd number. So, denote natin yung event sa pagkuha ng odd number as set O. So, ano na ba yung mga odd numbers from 1 to 6? So, 1, 3, and 5. So, therefore, number of elements of set O is 3 then. So, probability of getting odd number or event O is number of element of O over number of sample space, which is number of element of O is 3 over number of sample space is also 6. So, also 1/2. For C, probability of even number. So, denote natin as event E yun. So, ano na yung mga elements niya? So, ano yung even numbers from 1 to 6? 2, 4, 6. So, number of element of event E is 3. So, therefore, probability of event E or even number is number of element of event E over number of sample space. So, we have 3 over 6 or 1/2 then. Okay? Next, what is the probability of getting a heart-shaped card from a standard deck of cards? Okay, so ano raw yung probability na makakapili tayo ng heart-shaped na card from a standard deck of cards? So, ano muna yung sample space natin dito? So, number of sample spaces, alam natin yung isang deck of cards is merong 52 pieces of cards, right? And then, para naman sa heart shape, so, pangalan natin yung event na yon as event H. So, ano na yung mga elements ng heart shape card? So, from ace to 10, and then jack, queen, king, right? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then, jack, queen, king. So, ano yung number of elements nito? 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay? So, therefore, probability nitong event H na makakakuha tayo ng heart-shaped card is number of element of event H over number of sample space. So, we have 13 over 52. Or in lowest term, it is equal to 1/4. Okay? Next, we have a box contains 12 buttons identical in size and shape but not in color. There are 2 blue, 3 yellow, 6 black, and 1 white. Find the probability of selecting A, a blue button, B, a blue or yellow button, C, a green button, D, a blue, black, yellow, or white button. Okay, so dun muna tayo sa A, a blue button. So meron daw tayong total of 12 buttons na magkakaiba yung color. So therefore, yun yung number ng sample space natin, 12. So sa 12 buttons na yun, meron tayong 2 blue, 3 yellow, 6 na black, at 1 white. So find the probability of selecting for A, a blue button. So let's say event B yun, which is yung number of element niya is, base dito sa given is 2. So probability of event B is number of element of B over number of sample space. So we have 2 over 12 or 1/6. Okay? For B naman, a blue or yellow button. So let's name it as event B or Y. Okay? So ano yung number of elements nila? So pagsasamahin natin yung blue tsaka yellow. So ilan ba yung yellow? 3. Plus yung 2 blue, 5. Equal 5 yung total ng blue at yellow. So ngayon, ano yung probability nitong blue or yellow? So number of element of B or Y over number of sample space. So we have 5 over 12. Okay? C, a green button. So let's name it as event G. So ano number nung element nung event G na green button? So mapapansin nyo, wala tayong green button dito, right? So 0. So therefore, probability of event G is number of element of event G over number of sample space. So 0 over 12 or 0. So mapapansin nyo, 0 yung probability natin kasi imposible tayong makabunot ng green button kasi nga wala namang green button doon sa mga 12 buttons. Okay? Next for D, a blue, black, yellow, or white button. So lahat sila, right? So therefore, ano yung probability na mabubunot natin sila? Let's say all. Lahat sila. So 2 plus 3 plus 6 plus 1, 12, right? Over sample space na 12. So, 1. So, ibig sabihin, sure tayo na makakabunot tayo ng isa man lang dito sa blue, black, yellow, or white na button. Kasi yung probability natin is 1. Okay? Next, we have the table below shows the SAT math scores for 186 seniors at Garrison High School. If one senior is chosen at random, find A, the probability that the student had a score between 501 and 600, and B, the odds that the student scored between 301 and 500. So, dito muna tayo sa A. So, meron tayong table dito, yung scores daw sa SATMAT ng 186 seniors. So, yun bale yung number of sample space natin, 186. Ngayon, ang tanong sa A is probability that the student had a score between 501 and 600. So, titingin tayo dito sa column ng 501 to 600. So, ilang student ba yon? 62, right? So, probability is 62 over total of senior students is 186. So, in lowest term, it is equal to 1/3. Okay? Now, for B, the odds that the student scored between 301 and 500. So, ibig sabihin nito is odds in favor. So, ang formula natin kanina, odds in favor, is number of favorable outcome over number of unfavorable outcome or yung complement, right? So, from 300 to 500, so titingin tayo sa table, so itong dalawa, right? So, add natin itong 15 plus 35. Ilan yun? Yun yung favorable outcome. 50. Over number of unfavorable outcome. So, ano na yung mga number ng unfavorable outcome? Yung mga hindi na napili, which is itong 2 plus 62 plus 42 plus 30. So, ilan lahat yon? Or, minus nyo yung 186 minus 50. Right? 136. So, therefore, ito yung odds in favor. 50 over 136 or in lowest term, 25 over 68. Na kung gusto niyo yung odds against, i-reciprocal niyo lang to, so magiging 68 over 25. So ito yung against. Okay? Okay, so I think that's it for this video, Introduction to Probability. So sana ay may natutunan kayo sa video na to at maraming salamat sa panonood.